in the sports science lab, American gladiator and MMA fighter Justice Smith is ready to deliver a world record kick to combat key expert Kirby Roy's nuts. A boot that could cause a pelvic fracture or severe testicular injury. Can Kirby withstand the pain? Or will the kick turn his avocados into guacamole?
Three, two, one, go! Shins, like, man,
that was a strong kick,
man. No cup, no nothing, bro. It's just straight up nuts. my bad.
How did that feel?
It was a very strong direct kick. He had his shin into it. I mean, I can feel it coming up.
Wow.
Just as his foot rockets into Kirby's crotch at 22 miles an hour, landing with 1,100 pounds of force. That's even more powerful than his baseline kick. But instead of crumbling up and going full fetal, Kirby shrugs it off like it's nothing. How was Kirby able to take the massive impact below the belt and feel nothing? When Kirby's kicked in the groin, warning signals rocket to his brain at 265 miles an hour. In fractions of a second, the brain sends signals back down into the abdomen and testicles, and a neurotransmitter that tells the brain it's feeling pain is released. It's called Substance P. But after 5 years and thousands of the most painful shots to the nuts, Kirby's nerves process only 10% of the Substance P that a normal person would process. Which means his brain no longer receives a message of pain.
Your heart rate has not changed at all.
Wow.
Previously, in our tennis ball experiment, our subject's pulse redlined at 182 beats per minute after being plunked in the plump. But Kirby? Astonishingly, his heart rate stayed exactly the same, 85 beats per minute before, during, and after the kick. It's another sign that his brain isn't processing Substance P.
The hardest kick, I mean, the impact of it was tremendous.
Your shin went right up into his groin. What did you feel?
I felt his pelvic bone, and also a couple of nuts as well. But, dude, it was a real kick. Yeah, these two, it was real.
Substance P explains why Kirby didn't end up all wadded up, gasping for breath. But it doesn't explain how Kirby's pelvis and testicles weren't seriously damaged. After taking thousands of kicks to the groin for 5 years, Kirby's testicles toughened, and these repeated impacts created millions of microfractures in his pelvic bones. Due to an anatomical phenomenon called Wolf's Law, these fractures actually heal stronger, transforming those calcified bones into a substance harder than rock. That's right, Kirby stones are actually like stones.
I definitely tried to hit him as hard as I could. But he didn't faze him. But my mind is like, dude, I don't think he hit him hard because he's still standing. You know?
I gotta tell you, I was a total skeptic coming into this, but there was no trick to this.
No, I know the average guy would have been on his deathbed.
So if you want to challenge this new world record, keep in mind the words of the ancient Greek philosopher Testicles. Bravery and stupidity are often two peas in the same pod.
Those are unbelievable places, bro. A man shouldn't get hit that way.